Today, let's dive into the world of Gilmour Space, an Australian rocket company that's been making waves since its inception in 2015. With ambitious plans to build and launch orbital-class rockets from their own spaceport in Queensland, Australia, Gilmour Space has been steadily achieving milestones over the years. We'll start by exploring their journey since 2015, followed by a closer look at the talented team behind the company. Next, we'll look at the Eris orbital launch vehicle and its hybrid rocket engine. Finally, we'll wrap up with some exciting news about the highly anticipated first launch scheduled for later this year. In 2016, they launched Raster, their first privately developed hybrid rocket. This rocket used 3D printed fuel. The following year, in 2017, Gilmour Space began to attract substantial venture capital investment, helping them to advance their plans to provide satellite launch services. 2018 marked another important step forward for the company when they signed a Space Act agreement with NASA. This collaboration opened up exciting opportunities for joint space research, development, and educational initiatives. However, 2019 brought a setback when their planned small rocket launch suffered an anomaly just before launch. Despite the disappointment, the team managed to glean invaluable insights from the experience, which will help contribute to successful missions in the future. In September 2020, Gilmour Space made a significant stride by signing an agreement with Space Machines Company. Under this deal, Gilmour Space committed to launching a 35-kilo spacecraft into orbit, marking the largest payload ever announced by an Australian company at that time. In June 2021, Gilmour Space secured a significant Series C investment, further contributing to their status as Australia's top orbital launch provider. The following year, in May 2022, the company achieved a major milestone by winning a contract with the Australian Department of Defence to build and launch a new sovereign surveillance satellite. That same month, Gilmour Space successfully conducted a hot fire test of their Phoenix rocket engine, which powers the third stage of their Eris rocket. We'll cover the Eris rocket in more detail later. In August 2022, Commercial Space Technologies signed an agreement with Gilmour Space to offer a launch capacity of up to 50 kilos on the Eris Block 1 vehicle. The following month, in September 2022, Gilmour Space announced their first Caravan rideshare mission to low Earth orbit with an expected launch in late 2024. In November 2022, the Sirius hybrid rocket engine has completed its final qualification test, paving the way for the first orbital launch attempt. Fast forward to May 2023, when Australian Prime Minister Albanese made history by formally unveiling the Eris rocket, Australia's first domestically developed orbital launch vehicle. This event showcased the nation's growing presence in the global space industry. February 2024 brought more good news for Gilmour Space as the company announced a new Series D financing round. This funding amounted to $55 million, not only bolstering the company's resources, but also valuing the company at an impressive $605 million. In March 2024, a significant milestone was reached in Australia's space industry when the Bowen Orbital Spaceport was granted the country's first orbital launch facility license. This groundbreaking approval paves the way for the launch of rockets and satellites into low Earth orbit from the Bowen Orbital Spaceport, making a historic moment for Australia's space exploration. Now we've covered the main milestones since the company was founded, let's talk about the Gilmour brothers and their team. The founders of Gilmour Space are Adam Gilmour and James Gilmour. Adam is the CEO and James is the head of launch operations. Do you fancy working at a space company in Australia? You're in luck. Gilmour Space is hiring and have open positions in engineering, manufacturing, launch site operations, propulsion, software engineering, and more. Now let's turn to the Eris launch vehicle. This vehicle is a three-stage orbital class rocket. Depending on the orbit required, it can deliver up to 305 kilos or 672 pounds to low Earth orbit. Block 1 vehicle will be 23 metres tall, with a diameter of 2 metres for the first stage and 1.5 metres for the second stage. Fully fuelled, it weighs 35 tonnes. The Eris rocket uses a proprietary hybrid propellant technology that is safer and cheaper than traditional liquid and solid fuel rockets. If successful, it could be the first hybrid propelled rocket in the world to achieve orbit. Let's turn now to the Bowen Orbital Launch Facility. This spaceport is built and operated by Gilmour Space. It is Australia's first licensed orbital spaceport. From this spaceport, missions from 20 to 65 degrees, that's low to mid-inclination equatorial orbits, are possible. Test Flight 1. Gilmour Space is gearing up for a comprehensive end-to-end test of the entire Eris vehicle, including the hybrid propulsion engine, rocket design, structures, software, and guidance and control systems. This crucial test will also assess the ground support systems and infrastructure. As part of this mission, a test satellite bus will serve as the payload, with the goal of deploying it into low Earth orbit. The official launch date for the inaugural flight has not yet been determined, as Gilmour Space awaits final approvals from the Australian Space Agency, including the issuing of the launch permit. To stay up to date on the latest developments from Gilmour Space and other exciting space startups worldwide, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Don't miss out on any future videos. Thank you for watching, and please show your support by liking this video. It greatly helps us with the algorithm.